Learners, today we are going to discuss the global circulation of water. As you all know that water is the essential commodity and we should preserve it for the future generation. And in this today, the objective in the topic are what is meant by fresh water, importance of fresh water in nature, water as a renewable resource, identification of different sources of water and their importance for life, explanation of the terms like precipitation and evaporation, and then we will discuss the various steps involved in hydrological cycle. So, as you know that more than 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered by water, because of this the planet, it is called as blue planet. Water is an odorless, tasteless substance. It can naturally exist as gas, liquid and solid within a relatively narrow range of air temperature and pressure found on the earth's surface. It is absolutely essential for survival of all living beings. So, you can see the different water bodies which are present, like the ocean, river, pond, lake, streams. The global distribution of water: over 97% of water on earth is salt water, which is present in the oceans. We cannot drink salt water or use it for irrigation of crops, while only 2.7% of water is present on earth is fresh water. That contains less than 1000 ppm of dissolved solid of any type. About 2% of the earth's fresh water, that is about 66% of all fresh water, is in solid form, locked in ice caps of Antarctica and glaciers that occupy high alpine locations. Because it is frozen and far away, fresh water in ice caps is not available for use. So, only 1% of all the earth's water is in the form that can be used by humans, plants and animals. The fresh water is found in lakes, rivers, streams, ponds and in the ground, and only small amount, about 0.001% of water is found as vapor in the atmosphere. The distribution of fresh water, however, is geographically uneven, varying greatly from country to country and even within a country from one region to another region. We can summarize the distribution of water present on earth. Though water is a renewable resource, but fresh water is finite. Fresh water is a scarce resource in many parts of the world, including India. It is under increasing pressure as a result of pollution of water sources and increasing demand of growing population. Worldwide consumption of water has increased sixfold. This is more than twice the rate of population growth. On a daily basis, we use about 10 billion tons of fresh water worldwide. Average daily water usage in India is a person needs about 5 liters of water for drinking under moderate climate with little activity. It can go higher in adverse climate and with more activities. Globally, 4 trillion cubic meters of fresh water is consumed in a year. For agriculture, 75% to 90% of water is being used, and roughly 1 ton of grain requires 1000 tons of water. About 20% of water is used by industries and 10% in the domestic use. Fresh water withdrawals have tripled over last 50 years. Demand for fresh water is increasing 64 billion cubic meter a year. Now, importance of water for life and habitat. Water is a necessity for all life on earth. It is the most important component of protoplasm in the cells of living organism. 70% of our body is made up of water. Water is also the only source of hydrogen and one of the many sources of oxygen available to the body through metabolic processes. Water is also an important ecological factor that determines the structure and functioning of ecosystem. The cycling of all other elements depends on water as it serves as a medium for their transportation during the various steps and is the solvent medium for the nutrient uptake by the plants and other organisms. Freshwater ecosystems are the main sources for drinking water, agriculture, industry, sanitation, as well as for freshwater fisheries. Freshwater also provides recreational opportunities like swimming, rafting, snorkeling, and a means of transportation like ships, boats, canoe, etc. Freshwater ecosystems are home to numerous organisms like fish, amphibians, aquatic plants, and invertebrates. It has been estimated that 40% of all known fish species on Earth are found in freshwater ecosystems. Human survival since the ages depends on the relationship between human settlements and the availability of freshwater resources. Per capita availability of fresh water is declining all over the world. In the past, as a result of development and mismanagement of fresh water, there is a huge water shortage. Water crisis has not only affected crop production, but it has also impacted the environmental quality, wildlife, and other living creatures. Now we'll come to the global hydrological cycle. Continuous movement of water in all its form, whether it is ice, liquid, and vapor, by a system is known as hydrological cycle. The hydrological cycle involves three processes, which are evaporation and evapotranspiration, precipitation, and surface runoff. Atmospheric water, surface water, and groundwater are all parts of this hydrological cycle. We will now discuss in detail all the three points which I have mentioned above. So, first of all, we will take evaporation and evapotranspiration. The largest reservoir of water on the Earth's surface are the oceans, seas, and other water bodies like lakes, rivers, and streams, which provide about 90% moisture to the atmosphere through evaporation each day. So, evaporation can be defined as the phase where there is change of liquid water into vapor or gas on heating. The source of heat is the sun. Water from atmosphere is carried upward by the rising air currents. Some of portion of water vapor enters the atmosphere through sublimation, a process by which water changes from solid state, which is ice, directly into vapor without changing into liquid form. Plants lose large quantities of water through transpiration, releasing about 10% of the water in the atmosphere. Since it is difficult to separate the process of transpiration and evaporation, the term evapotranspiration is generally used for describing the combined process of evaporation and transpiration. These three processes, that is evaporation, transpiration, and evapotranspiration, together provide all the water to the atmosphere. The second one is the precipitation. High up in the atmosphere, the air cools and loses its capacity to hold water vapor. As a result, the excess of water condenses, that is, it changes from vapor to liquid and forms cloud droplets. The droplets ultimately grow in size and cause precipitation. There are four major types of precipitation, namely drizzle, rain, snow, and hail. Thus, most of the water is returned to the ocean and on land in the form of rain, snow, hail, etc. Surface runoff. When precipitation falls over land, it travels through various routes. Some of it evaporates back into the atmosphere, some of it enters the ground and is stored as groundwater. Groundwater is found in two layers of the soil. The one is zone of aeration, where the gaps are completely filled with water. And the second is zone of saturation, where the gaps are filled with air as well as water. Boundary between these two zones is known as the water table, which rises or falls as the level of groundwater increases or decreases. At different stages of the water cycle, human beings and other organisms intercept it and withdraw water for their use. As water continually evaporates, condenses, and precipitates, the rate of evaporation and rate of precipitation at a global level is equal to the total amount of water vapor in the atmosphere is approximately the same over time. But evaporation over the continents is less than precipitation, while the converse is true over the oceans. Now, natural stores of water in the global hydrological cycle is as which is given in percentage. In the ocean, it's 97.71%, ice caps 1.9%, groundwater 0.5%, soil moisture 0.01%, lakes and rivers 0.009%, and atmosphere 0.0001%. Balance and stores of water. The total volume of water in hydrological cycle is estimated approximately to be 1.384 million kilometers square. The global water cycle involves many complex pathways and stores. Most of the fresh water is stored as ice and in polar caps and in the glaciers. If all of this ice were to melt, then it would release enough water to keep the rivers of the world flowing for up to 1000 years. Though rivers play a vital role in water cycle, they are not the major stores of water in the way that oceans are. Lakes store more water than rivers and for a longer time. About 2/3 of all fresh water on the surface is stored in the 250 large lakes of the world. Water moves through these stores and this movement keeps the hydrological cycle running. Though different stores keep the water for different times. Ocean, ice caps and glaciers are long-term stores, whereas rivers and atmosphere are short-term stores. Now, induce changes in the hydrological cycle. Human activities deliberately or accidentally has altered the global water cycle in many ways. The movement of water vapor across ocean and continents are altered by air pollution, which causes global warming. Now, causing changes in precipitation patterns, inevitable as precipitation is dependent on ambient temperature. Evaporation rate and pattern change due to altered ground surface conditions. For example, urbanization or development of reservoirs affect evaporation rate. Increasing or decreasing the length or density of the river channels can directly change river runoff. Groundwater can be affected by pumping out excessive water that lowers the water table or through increased percolation due to water logging, to development of reservoirs and dams. Altering the vegetation pattern from deforestation, cropping or afforestation, etc., can significantly greater influence of runoff water. Water is probably the most important renewable natural resource on planet Earth. It is essential for life, and since the earliest time, humans have relied on fresh water ecosystems for drinking water, for agriculture, industry, sanitation, as well as for food. Much water is being used inefficiently and polluted through human activities, and per capita availability of fresh water is declining all over the world. Fresh water resources form an intrinsic part of the Earth's hydrological cycle. Water is evaporated from oceans, rivers, lakes, and vegetation, thus becomes part of the atmospheric moisture. Global winds distribute this across the Earth's surface. Condensation creates clouds, and precipitation brings it back to the surface from where it evaporates to re-enter the global water cycle. Human activities can alter the global hydrological cycle in several ways. So, we can just summarize whatever we have read just now in few points. Like, water is probably the most important renewable natural resource on the planet Earth. About 97.41% of the water on Earth is salt water found in the ocean. So, learners, this is all about the global distribution of water. So, what we have learnt is that we have to conserve water for our use and for the future, the hydrological cycle which is going on around, and how you can do, what steps you can take to preserve water. Thank you.